All right. Round number one. Let's see if we can't make this mana work. Got a lot of mana fixing, but not a lot of natural mana. You know, not a lot of naturally good mana. I think our spells are great. So that's what I'll be looking for here. All right, well, we got pretty lucky. Hitting a Crumbling Necropolis is a good start, kind of no matter what. Seagate Oracle is a nice one, too. All right, this could work out. Because once we start chaining Urban Evolutions together, assuming we're not just getting rocked, we should be in good shape. Okay, Burning Tear Emissary into something's not good for us. Yeah, wow, 5 power on turn 2. That's impressive. Can't cast that. Not yet, anyway. All right, go ahead. Probably going to have to get an island with this thing so that we can cast Mistraven. Looking for lands. Not going to be greedy. So we'll probably, just as things sit, we'll probably just Mistraven next turn. And get rid of the Mog Flunkies. Ooh. That was a nice draw. Still probably correct to just Mistraven here, though. Get rid of the Flunks. And then we take no damage this turn. We can block one and block the other. And then I can just start chaining these Urban Evolutions together or leave up Mystic Genesis or whatever. I guess I block here. It's going to pass. I've got teachings. I can search something up. I don't even remember what I can get, but I can get something. And if I Mystic Genesis something here, it's pretty good for me too. And I do take 3, which is annoying. But I'm using the mana no matter what. Yeah, this seems good. Make a 4/4. I like that. Whoop. Now we're going nuts. It's going to pass here. We're at 8. We got to be mindful of our life total. Yeah, for reasons like this. This is pretty good. With these ones and just leave back the Oracle just in case there's haste or something I'm not thinking of. I don't think the one damage is super relevant. Aha! Who's a genius? I don't know. I might be. I might not be, though. I might be very dumb. 4, 7, 8. Let's Night Terrors in case there's anything super scary. Advent of the Worm. Can you cast this? No. Thunderous Wrath? No. Craterhoof Behemoth? Not even close. Call the Conclave? Yes, but it's not very good. I think the scariest card might just be Thunderous Wrath here. This is actually fairly scary too. All they need is a green or white mana source and they can fire that thing off. And I don't have great answers. I suppose I don't have bad answers for it though. So let's take the Thunderous Wrath away. Now I have kind of an interesting choice. I don't really want to take two from this, but it's not the end of the world. Could Soul Ransom it. I think I'm just going to be a little greedy here and kind of try to go big. Seven you pass. Play call, sure. I jump block here. That's a good draw, too. And 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I've got 10 mana to play with here. I don't think they have any outs to this stuff, right? All right. Well, I think Basilisk Caller is probably pretty good against this opponent. It doesn't take much. And the life gain can be really, really relevant. Could actually change my deck around pretty significantly if I want. Like, I can kill the red. Do something like this, because it's just like we're facing down just basically a creature based deck, and we'd I think prefer to just be a little more streamlined against it rather than have the more greedy stuff like Cruel Ultimatum. I don't think we need, like, we've just got removal spells, counter spells, you know, control type stuff, and I think I'm going to just slim down the deck to that rather than go for the, because our main deck configuration is more geared towards a controlling matchup. And that's just not the matchup we're in right now. And we're playing against Call the Conclave. Important to play my island here so that I have the opportunity to play Coiling Oracle turn two if I draw an untapped green source, or I could play Explore. Oh, I did. You know, do I just want to kill the Centaur? This is actually an interesting choice. Now that our opponent has played Call the Conclave, it's not unreasonable to just snap it off, and I think I'm going to do that. The thing is that you don't want to let your opponent untap and have the option to populate, and then all of a sudden you're facing down two or three of those things. Ooh, that's interesting. that was lucky. Wow. That was really lucky. Okay. Go. I'll block this one, but we do need to find some action here. Well, we did. Let's just go big. Hopefully soul manipulation here. And I get to. I'm just going to get back the Coiling Oracle just to help us keep kind of plowing through our library here. Because we are a little heavy on the lands this game. Okay, rewind's not bad. We're one mana short from being able to kill this turn and also rewind, though. So I will be patient. It is revealed as well, right? Yeah, opponent can see that. No, it's okay. Jesus, I'm snapping that off. What do I want? Mystic Genesis? It's kind of interesting. My opponent doesn't really need to do anything, but I am going to kill the flunkies anyway. And the Spire Monitor doesn't block that well, so I'll just take that. Lots of lands. Perhaps too many. Kill the flunks. Take one. And let's just go get a Spire Monitor here. It's a good draw. Okay, I think we're pretty close to being set here. I'm going to take one here just to leave up Genesis for any creatures. And then I'll just go Spire Monitor. And then next turn I can have both up. Fiery Justice. Two to that, three to me. I gain an extra couple. I don't love losing the Seagate Oracle there, but it's not like a huge source of value for us anyway. And we should be pretty well set now. I've got Spire Monitor plus Mystic Genesis. Two turns. The Marigold Thunderous Wrath. Okay. I suppose I just counter it. It's going to kill one of our... Oh, you're going to aim it at me. Well... I think that's still worth doing because I get to eat a goblin here and I still have Seal of Doom in case my opponent has Craterhoof Behemoth, which we saw in their hand in the first game. And if they have Craterhoof Behemoth, then we can kill the Craterhoof. And yes, these creatures would get a bonus, but it probably isn't going to be enough to be lethal since we can control this population. Second main phase, huh? What are you going to steal? Seal of Doom? All right, well, that's game. All right. Made a pretty big adjustment there for game two, but I think it was correct. Let's go to the next match.